Hello, and welcome to the Yesterday Show. Today, we're going to start with a new segment of the show, Thought for the Week. And I welcome onto the show our resident philosopher, Roger Ingerman.
Hello, Mr. Wales.
Now, I understand you're going to teach us a lesson about relationships.
Yes, that is what I intended to do, yes, if I may.
Where does today's reading come from?
The reading today is taken from the first book of Kings, chapter 6, verses 4 onwards towards the end of the chapter. I met her in a club down in old Soho where you drink champagne and it tastes just like cherry cola. C-O-L-A. Cola. She walked up to me and she asked me to dance. I asked her name and in a dark brown voice she said, Lola. L-O-L-A. Lola. Low, 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 low. Lola. Well, I'm not the world's most physical guy, but when she squeezed me tight, she nearly broke my spine. Oh, my Lola. Low, 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 Lola. Well, I'm not dumb, but I can't understand why she walked like a woman and talked like a man. Oh, my Lola. Low, 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 Lola. Low, 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 Lola.
Thanks for that, Roger. And now on to our interview segment. And I'm very glad to welcome veteran broadcaster Frederick Snore, who's with us in the studio to talk about the Leonids, a yearly meteor shower that always occurs around this time of year. Frederick. Frederick? Mr. Snore!
Sorry, Mr. Wales, I've overslept. Sorry.
As I was saying, it's that time of year again when the Leonids fall from the sky. Could you give us more details about this phenomena?
Yes, I suppose I could. Like you say, they are this particular meteor shower is called the Leonids. It occurs every year around this time, mid-November. And it is a meteor shower that is a shower caused by the presence of meteors.
Okay, is there any additional information you can tell us about this meteor shower?
Well, this particular meteor shower is very important in our solar system, partially because it occurs once a year, always roughly on the same date every year, so it's a very regular thing. The other, because it is meteor showers are usually a spectacular sight, so it's very pretty.
Okay, I understand that the cause of this meteor shower is the yearly arrival of the comet Temple Tuttle.
Yes, that is correct. That was the word I was searching for. Temple Tuttle was on the tip of my tongue. Yes, this comet Temple Tuttle is the cause of this meteor shower. Did you know it occurs at the same time every year?
I think you've just told us that.
Oh,
Mr. Snore.
I do apologise for that. I have a habit of repeating myself.
As we all well know. In what way should this meteor shower be observed? Do you need protective glasses?
No, it's not like an eclipse where you have the piece of card with a pinhole in and special glasses and everything. It's, I would say the best way to observe this is stand in a field and wait.
Wait to what date exactly?
Any time in the middle of the month will be fine.
Can you tell the listeners the exact date of this meteor shower?
The exact date of the meteor shower is November. Yes, it's November.
November the...
Just November.
For those listeners wanting to view the meteor shower, you probably all well know that it's on November the 17th.
Yes, that was the thing I was searching for. I just... My brain is not as quick as it once was.
Now, I understand, Frederick, you've invested £50 in a telescope recently.
Yes.
What type of telescope is this? Is this a Galilean telescope? Frederick?
Yes,
is it a Galilean telescope?
No, it's my telescope. It's mine. I bought this with my money and it's mine.
Yes, but is it a Galilean telescope?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. It's a Galilean telescope. That is a telescope which is Galilean.
Would you advise the listeners to get one of these to watch the event, watch the meteor shower?
Yes. And it's a very complicated issue, you see. Yes, because it's, mine seems to be working fine. No, because I don't want you taking it.
But people can surely buy their own telescopes.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. I thought you meant to... No, buy mine. I'm not selling mine. No, of course not. I paid £50.
Frederick, it's been great having you on the show. I'm sure you've informed the listeners far more than I could have done. Can somebody cart this guy off, please? And now, with a lack of alternatives, we're back to Alex as our international correspondent. And to all intents and purposes, he is supposed to be interviewing Lewis Hamilton. But based on his previous efforts, I very much doubt it. Oh well. Over to you, Alex.
Hi, Tom.
Let's get it out of the way. Are you actually in Leamington?
Yes. Yes, but Lewis Hamilton's here. I've got him on the line. Look, I'll prove it. Hello, Lewis.
Thank you very much for the warm welcome.
Well, carry on, Alex.
Thank you. I will. I'm sorry that connection's a bit poor. It's quite hard to hear you.
They're very, very hard.
Well, I apologise. But surely when it comes to comfort, Formula One cars are also very hard places to spend your time in.
You just hit a bump. You try to correct it, and the thing will, you know, it will shoot you off.
Ooh, that doesn't sound good. Do you still get nervous before races?
I've had that problem this year a couple of times.
But you're cured now!
What do you think?
Well, I don't know. Surely having your beautiful girlfriend has made your life a lot easier.
Honestly, having someone that could push me all the way was wicked.
Oh, really?
What do you think?
So how does Nicole help you before race day?
Bracing myself, and I put my head back, and it was actually quite a nice shunt.
Shunt?
And I shunted it.
You shunted it?
Yeah.
Moving on.
Pretty cool. But then you see it coming, you're like, oh, it's gonna hurt. And then you hit it.
Moving on! You'd say you want to stay with McLaren Mercedes for the rest of your career.
I don't know.
Having second thoughts, then? Has Ferrari been pestering you?
I'm actually a bit nervous about this, because I had some fun out there, actually. But I'm not here to compete. Let's see what goes on.
Alex, could you ask him about the spying fiasco from last year?
Certainly. Lewis, would you care to elaborate?
I've had that problem this year a couple of times.
Really? The press said it occurred only once.
I had a really good one this year, which was at the beginning of the season.
I see. Surely if McLaren was involved in even more spying, we'd have heard it before.
And I shunted it.
What?
I shunted it.
Okay.
Is something the matter, Alex?
And I shunted it.
What?
Nothing, nothing, nothing. No, nothing.
Alex, are you sure that's Lewis Hamilton?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Hello, Lewis.
Yeah.
What is your full name?
What do you think?
No, you tell me.
I don't know.
Alex, that really isn't Lewis, is it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
You're just using sound clips of Lewis Hamilton from a Top Gear interview, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I am Jeremy Clarkson. I am Jeremy Clarkson.
Yeah.
I don't believe you.
Fine then. Don't believe me. But I know that, at least in my mind, Lewis is here with me, and I am on Top Gear. And those two other guys from Top Gear are here. That one, you know, and the other guy. Yeah. Yeah, I am Jeremy Clarkson, really.
Yeah.
Well, I always thought it was too good to be true, to believe that you could actually get such an interview. Alex, go home and garrote yourself.
But I am home. What's a garrote?
Alex! And now back to mumbling on.